In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this light travel effect animation by using the particle emitter's die on hit feature. The idea is to create a certain animation so that we don't see any particles penetrating through the mesh in the middle. We can use the die on hit feature to stop any particles colliding with any meshes that has the collision physics enabled. That way, if we look at the mesh from a certain angle, we can create an illusion of the mesh traveling fast. The last thing we want is a tip of the stopped particle mesh showing up after penetrating the mesh in the middle like this. In order to make sure we don't see any parts of the particle meshes that have stopped after hitting the middle mesh, we must move the particle mesh's origin away from the world center. I'll show you the material details. This is what I'm talking about. Select the particle mesh, go to edit mode, and move it away from the world center like this. Now the middle mesh looks like it's traveling fast. The collided particle mesh stopped and it's hidden from the camera angle. There's even better way, and that is to place a duplicated collision mesh right next to the emitter mesh. If we do this, the mesh won't fall any near the middle mesh, and we can place the camera in different angles. The particle mesh was created by using a subdivided cube. I subdivided the cube and scaled it on the Z axis. I have used another sphere to block the environment light for the final animation render. Here are the particle emitter settings. Please remember to activate the die on hit setting, so that the particle mesh will stop when it hits the collision mesh. For the collision mesh, I'm using the default setting. By the way, if your particle meshes fall weirdly, meaning in the wrong angle, please try this. Select the particle mesh, go to edit mode, and rotate it to find the correct angle. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.